Hey Charles, how's it going? Pretty good, just catching up on some reading. How about you?
Ah, the usual. Doing some coding and hanging out in Discord.
I saw that. In fact, I was just catching up on your conversation in the Beginner Questions channel.
And I'm guessing you saw that question about MVC.
Yep, we actually get that one a lot.
Tell me about it. I never really know how to respond. I mean, I know the answer is that you just shouldn't use MVC in Unity, but it's so hard to explain why.
Yeah, that's actually why I called. A lot of beginners ask about MVC and design patterns in general. So figured we could just talk it out and come up with a good response once and for all.
Yeah, that'd be great. And you know what? We could even pin it to the channel so we can reference it later.
Huh, that's a great idea. Are you free right now?
Yeah, let's do it.
Cool. So how do you think we should approach this?
Well, in this case, he's asking about MVC, but he didn't mention what he was trying to implement. We should probably try to find that out so we have some context.
Good point. Why don't you just go ahead and ask him?
All right, yeah, one sec. All right, let's see what he says.
I'm willing to bet he's trying to add a user interface to his game. Beginners tend to lean on MVC for UIs.
How come?
Well, in my experience, someone who knows enough about code to ask about model view controllers probably comes from a web dev background, which makes sense because a lot of professional software developers try their hand at game dev in their free time.
It's funny you should say that because I used to be a web developer myself. And you know, now that I think about it, every single web app I worked on was built on an MVC framework.
Well, it's a great design pattern for web applications.
Yeah, but not so great for game development.
You can say that again.
Looks like he responded. Well, there you go. We just need to explain that MVC isn't a good pattern to use for UIs in games.
Maybe. I mean, it's a good discussion to have, but there's a fundamental problem that we still need to address.
Oh yeah? What's that?
Let's think it through. Based on what he's saying, it sounds like he hasn't even written any code yet.
Huh, you're right. It's almost like he's trying to use MVC as a sort of blueprint for his logic. Which obviously isn't the correct approach. In fact, I just finished reading that famous design pattern book by the Gang of Four, and I might have some notes that we could use. Ah, here it is. Design patterns were created to help developers talk about how they solve certain problems. They aren't instructions for writing code, but a way to describe commonly used solutions.
Exactly. Writing code through the lens of which design patterns you're gonna use always leads to logic that's way more complicated than it needs to be.
Right, because design patterns describe complete solutions that are usually overkill for things that most developers face on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah, you typically don't need an entire infrastructure or architectural overhaul. You can overcome most decision points with a few lines of simple code.
I learned that lesson the hard way.
Unfortunately, most developers do. But I think we're ready to craft a response that'll hopefully spare our beginner here from a lot of headaches.
Awesome.
Why don't you start by letting him know that we understand where he's coming from? Then we can steer him in the right direction.
All right.
Nice. Great start.
Thanks. Now, we just need to let them know where we stand on design patterns in general.
Right. Why don't you lead by explaining what they are and how they were intended to be used?
Okay.
All right, now hit him with the problem.
Now finish strong. I hope this makes sense.
Drop mic.
Nicely put. And look, he's already responding.
Oh, yeah.
This is a common fear among beginners. There's so many ways to structure your code that it really can be overwhelming.
I know that feeling. I'm like the poster child for anxiety-induced paralysis by analysis.
Yeah, but you got better, right?
I did, over time. It just took me putting in the work and gaining the experience I needed to feel confident.
I think that sounds like some pretty good advice.
Huh. Yeah. I hope that's helpful.
I think so. And it looks like he does too.
Well done, Bartles. I think we handled that very well.
Me too. Thanks for your help.
You're welcome. It's important that we work together when people in our community run into problems. This should be a safe place for beginners and more experienced game devs alike.
Definitely.
Oh, and now we can actually pin this response for future use.
That's right. I'll do that as soon as I get back to my computer.
Awesome. Well, man, I've got a long coding session ahead of me, so I'll let you get back to your book.
Sounds good to me.
Enjoy.
Will do.
Catch you later, man.
Bye.
Thank you to all of my patrons, and a special shout out to John Nix, Rob Homewood, DJ Weaver, Serv Chatterjee, Jennifer, Christian, Uriser, Alwin Caravilla, Umit Sarin, Dustin, Piach Bungo, Usafali Castle, and Trond. Thanks, guys.